The president of the United States has just fired the person in charge of election security who issued the statement saying these are the most secure elections in American history, saying he's firing him because he doesn't like what he said and that everything he said is wrong just because Trump is saying so.
Yeah, the president is making very clear here. He's not even trying to tiptoe around the fact that he is firing this official because he is contradicting the president's baseless conspiracy theories that the president has been spreading around to try and, you know, legitimize his election laws, to try and vindicate himself. The president making very clear that this election, in his view, has been rigged and has been riddled with voter fraud. And that is exactly what Christopher Krebs, the head of the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency, has said did not happen. He has said this was the most secure election in history. He has also swatted down the president's conspiracy theory about this Dominion voting software machine, saying that there is no evidence, as the president has suggested, that any of this software had deleted votes or attributed votes to another candidate, despite what the president has said here. So this is something that Christopher Krebs and his team knew was coming. He had been very aware in the days leading up to this that he expected to likely be fired by the president of the United States. And obviously it is happening in the same fashion that we have seen with so many other officials firing via tweet.
You know, it is stunning, Jeremy, that he's doing this, right? I mean, it's every single thing in here is counterfactual. To the extent that anything would have impacted this election, which he lost resoundingly, 306 electoral college votes. It was a resounding win when Trump won it in 2016. It's a resounding win for Biden now. Is there anyone, Jeremy, from your understanding, who's even in the room with him? Or is he just in there doing this stuff? He's going on Twitter, fires the defense secretary. Going on Twitter a few days later, fires the guy who's in charge of election integrity in this country. He's just in there like crazy tweeting?
Well, he's certainly still in touch with officials. I mean, there are still folks at the White House who are around him, but we've learned that he's been spending most of his mornings at the White House, inside the residence of the White House, watching TV, heading to the Oval Office much later than he usually does. So he is certainly spending more time alone processing all of this. And the other thing to point out is there are different views in the president's ear, as there are so often. Right now, you're at a point where Rudy Giuliani, the former New York City mayor, is telling the president that he has a shot here, screaming at Trump campaign attorneys late last week and telling them that they are liars for telling the president that his legal battles here are a long shot in terms of overturning the results of the election. And then on the other hand, you have other folks telling the president it's time to start acknowledging reality. So there's no question that he's hearing a lot of different things right now. And there are obviously still those voices encouraging the president to go deeper and deeper into this conspiracy theory territory. And some of the members of the president's legal team right now are pushing that very same narrative, including Sidney Powell, an attorney who's working with the president, who's pushed all kinds of crazy conspiracy theories, including stating that the CIA has been involved in altering votes in this election, which is, of course, not true, completely unfounded. Yeah. But clearly the president wants to go deeper into this. And that's what we're seeing with this firing of Christopher Krebs as he continues to deny reality. Aaron.
All right. Thank you very much. I hope none of these people ever have to spend time in places in the world where these kind of conspiracy theories actually get traction and you live in the kinds of governments that create that. Phil Mudd joins me on the phone. So, Phil. Obviously, former counterterror official and at the CIA, our analyst. So, Phil, your reaction here. The president has now gone on Twitter and fired the guy who came out, who ran the election, right, said this is the most secure election in American history, right, with the backing of the full United States government. The president has fired this guy. There he is, Christopher Krebs, putting out a whole bunch of lies. I don't even want to keep repeating them, but lies, saying that, you know, the election was taken from him.
Yeah, I think there's a couple of reactions. There's a personal piece of someone who served in government for a couple decades, and that piece is, I mean, firing people on Twitter. I don't want to belabor this, Aaron, but firing people on Twitter. Remember, for James Comey, the FBI director, the president couldn't fire him in person. He sent over one of his personal assistants to do it. Talk about low budget. But the more serious question is, look, we're about 2 months, maybe a little more than 2 months to the inauguration. In between there, we have two major vacation periods. We've got Thanksgiving. We've got Christmas. This is not about taking someone out of a position and putting in someone who's more loyal. As a president who's about to leave his position, you don't have time to do that. You've got less than 2 months if you take out the vacation time. This is about spite. I'm angry. I don't have that much time left. So the people who didn't support me, they're gone. whether it's at defense, at CIA, at FBI, they're gone. This is about spite. It's not about policy, and it's certainly not about replacing somebody with a person who's more loyal, because you just don't have time to do that.
No, you don't. All right. I want to bring in Ben Hovland as well, who is the chairman of the U.S. Election Assistance Commission. And I believe when you and I talked the other day, Ben, you've worked with Mr. Krebs. You know him. What's your reaction here to what the president of the United States has just done?
Yeah. You know, I don't have official confirmation yet that what has happened. Obviously, I saw the tweet, certainly concerning. You know, my experience with Director Krebs is that he's been a great director of CISA, showed a lot of leadership, particularly in the election space. I know he has done a great job pulling together the team and have enjoyed working with him on election issues. We had, you know, such a success story this year as far as what we were able to do through the critical infrastructure subsector, that partnership working on a range of issues, of course, primarily around cybersecurity, but a lot of work was done as well in response to the pandemic and running elections this year in these challenging times.
So, Ben, you come out, your team, right? You're saying this is the most secure election in American history. The president of the United States now just fires the guy who was, you know, in charge of cybersecurity and intelligence here, and comes out and says that that statement was inaccurate, and then goes on to list a whole bunch of things saying that this election, you know, massive fraud. What is your response to that? You just sat there and spent your entire professional life running this election, coming up with the most secure election in American history, and the president of the United States has just come out and said that's BS.
You know, I think it's very concerning. I think that, as I've said to you before, I wish that the rhetoric we would keep hearing would match up with the court filings. You know, again, the professionals that run this election, folks that worked on securing this election, they dedicated a lot of their lives to this, put in a lot of hours working on this to make this election run as smoothly as it did. And again, if there are any issues, you know, those should be investigated. But what we keep seeing in the court filings doesn't add up to the rhetoric. Certainly, that is that's concerning. And again, what we need to base our understanding of elections on, the will of the people, is on facts and truth. And you know, when you talk to election officials across the country, they're confident in the security of this election. They're confident in the outcome of the election, that this was a fair election and that Americans made their voices heard. And we've got to respect the will of the people and the public servants that helped run this election and make this
okay.
All possible.
So he doesn't respect it. And he says, you guys are all wrong and all this is lies. He keeps putting these falsehoods out there. So he just fired, you know, Mr. Krebs. He could fire you by tweet any moment, right? I mean, I presume you expect that to be possible, right?
I'm in a little different position. So we are an independent bipartisan agency at the Election Assistance Commission. I guess that's certainly possible to try. There's any number of things that you can put on Twitter, as we've learned. But again, to me, this is about respecting the will of the American people, respecting our democracy. And you know, I can just say that the work, you know, it's been an honor to work with Chris Krebs and his team. They did an amazing job reaching out to state and local election officials. Since 2016, there's really just been a sea change in information sharing across state, local, and federal government. That has really, you know, when we talk about our confidence in the security of this election, in the processes and procedures that were in place, you know, so much of that is because the work that has gone in since 2016 to improve that information sharing, improve the security of our elections, put in place additional safeguards. And so, again, a lot of that credit goes to Director Krebs, goes to his team for the work that they've done.
All right. Well, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much, Ben Hovland, as the president has just fired another person by tweet and in the president's tweet, putting a whole bunch of falsehoods.